I am trying my best to remember. I thought I, like, killed myself or something so I could get back up there, but I don't think it's that. I don't think I would have to kill myself, would I? I don't know, maybe I do. Come here, guard. Kill me. Are you retarded? Yeah, okay. Spend your time doing that. I think I do have to die, because I don't really see any other way to get back up there. I mean, maybe there is? But I don't see it. Oh yeah, now I do. Once I'm almost dead. You can just... Yeah, wow. Alright, so that's one way. Just lower my health. Yeah, you can get out right here. I didn't know that. Yeah, guys, I'm an effing moron sometimes, I know. Oh my goodness, that was a huge waste of time. Wow. And it would have been even worse if I'd got myself killed. I mean, I guess it would have spawned right here, but... There is a way. There was a way. And it was simple. It was right in front of me. Alright. Now I have to... Yep, he did it again. You know what, guys? I'm just going to cut it until I get back up there. Alright, guys. I am back up here, and the way to get around this other guard is to stay inside the barrel even longer, and you'll come up behind him. And take his key and then murder him because of all the trouble he's caused us, and then we can unlock the winch, or I guess it'll just drop the heart. So there we go, can grab the heart right here. It is a big heart, very big, and Sly seems very happy. I guess that's bad news for Rajan. He can't have any more of his illegal spices. Alright, so we're a quarter way through the game in percentage-wise. And, yeah. I think we can exit back over here. And have a happy time. Good thing I didn't fall right there, or otherwise I'd have to come all the way back up a third time. Alright, so we are done with that mission. And now... there should be two Sly missions. Yes, there they are. Rip off the ruby and spice grinder destruction. I think I'm going to go with rip off the ruby just because it's closer. And let's do it. I think this is more of like a Murray and Bentley mission. But Sly starts it. So... And I missed that. Wow. That's alright, I will find another way back up there. I don't think I could have really, you know, gone that way anyways. I think I was at a dead end. So, in a way, it is kind of good that I fell. Always looking on the bright side. I'm gonna run up here and make our way around to the front of the palace with the big elephant tusks. And then we can head across the bridge to the ruby. Well, I have to get up there. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, just wasting time. Why did I think I could come over here and do this? I have to get up on that vine up there, so... I'm just gonna meet you guys up there when I get to the ruby, okay? Not waste more of your time. Alright guys, I am now back up here. Well, not back, because I was never up here. But I'm up here where the ruby is, so we can start the mission.
We've been contracted to acquire that huge ruby of Rajan's for a local crime ring. In exchange for the goods, they'll set us up with a Cherry Bomb 500 for the heist.
A Cherry Bomb 500? That's a lot of kick.
Trust me, we'll need it. To get that ruby free from its moorings, you might have to whack it a few times with your cane.
I'm on it.
Alright, so I guess that's the only reason we needed to get up here. Couldn't Bentley have just, like, thrown a bomb or something? I mean... Aren't we damaging this thing? Me hitting it with a cane and then letting it fall? I don't know. Looks like two stories. It does look pretty high up.
Muscle on the way!
The annoying part about this is, as Murray, we have to run all the way over there instead of, I don't know, him running up in a cutscene or something. Oh my goodness. Don't like doing, you know, busy work. Things that do not need to be done. Well, I guess it needs... I need to get over there. But it's just a waste of time. The game should have, I don't know... I mean, every other time Bentley and Murray have gotten somewhere, they've just run like that. They're like, oh, I'm here now. Let's body slam this guy just for the hell of it. And then move along. Move along, move along. Let's jump around this guy because he thinks he's pretty smart by blocking the entrance with his flashlight, but he's not. Took him out. Alright, this rhino looks like he wants to fight. Yeah, get out of here. Okay. Alright, so... I think... Yeah, now we go across the bridge. I kind of got it mixed up with Sly earlier. I was thinking we could get up here just by running over here, but this is with the part for the part with Murray.
Murray, you could pick up the ruby with your stomp move. Despite its size, that rock...
See, Bentley ran over here just now. Why couldn't Murray? Alright, Murray, did you have to use your binoculcom? You're 2 feet away. he was using his binoculcom to look at something that is literally 2 or 3 feet away. So, you can't run with this object, but there is, and you can't jump. There is a power-up later in the game that enables you to jump while holding stuff, so that's a pretty cool power-up. The thing with Murray's power-ups, they're more of just to... make him better. Like, I mean, yeah, that's what all power-ups do, but you know what I mean? They're not really, like, additions. They're kind of just helping him. Like, they're more to help, how should I say this, make him better as a person. Like, you know, Sly, he doesn't need his... Okay, yeah, here, let me stop talking to show you guys this weird guy right here.
I'll recommend to my superiors that we purchase it.
Yeah, so some really freaky voiced guy. He has a really weird voice, by the way. He's the guy we're selling the ruby to, but anyways, like I was saying, Sly and his power-ups, like, he doesn't need them. You can just play the game and have an easy time playing a Sly without any of his power-ups. They're just additions. With Murray, it's almost as if you need his power-ups to play as him. Like, he's bad without them. Like, you can't do things in the game without him, without his power-ups. I guess these guards are going to be assholes, try to mess the rupee up. Not rupee, ruby. Why do I keep messing that up? Keep calling it a rupee. This is not Zelda. This is Sly Cooper. Alright, let's continue on our way. I don't know what you're thinking, Bentley. I can't make it across this rope. The hell? I think I can make it up over there, though. Oh, body slam. Hold on, let me see my power-ups. I do not have the flaming fist or whatever, so I can't take these guys out really easily. But I can body slam over and over. You guys want some of this? You want some Murray? About to go ham with Murray. Look at all these guards coming at me. Yeah, you guys don't want none of this. Come here, piece of shit. There we go. Get some coins. And this is the final destination for the ruby. There we go. I think if I had gotten attacked, I'd have to start over.
The Cooper gang certainly lives up to its reputation. This is a true Indian treasure. We will honor the bargain and provide a cherry bomb 500 at the time the turtle requests.
The dude just puts it in his pocket. What the hell? The guy just slides the, what was that, like a 500 pound ruby in his pocket? Oh my goodness. This game cracks me up sometimes. Alright, so we've got another Sly mission and another Bentley mission, guys. So let's head back and do them really quick. Kill you, because you're annoying. and I actually want to check if there's anything to sell. Probably not. Yep, there's a gold ring, so turn to Sly, and we will be on our way to the next mission.